Myah, you know, you start off 14-0, and I'm sure you guys always want to start fast, and that was obviously a key to it, but when you're playing a team that you're heavily favored to beat, is that something you talk about? Like, let's try to start early, because, you know, the longer you let them hang in it, so to speak, the easier it is for them to make it a game.
Yeah, I think that's kind of our approach for any team, you know, that we play throughout the years. We just want to get a good start on it, and mainly just for us to get, you know, our feet wet and kind of get into our system and kind of get a rhythm into it. So I think that's just a mentality we like to have, you know, going into any game.
Tori, you guys are good at that, you know, starting games, and a lot of times too, you see it in the third quarter, you come out of halftime and start really fast too. What do you think contributes to that?
I think just us being aware and having that energy to start with, you know, obviously for us helps us get going too, but I think we just really make it a priority to start really each quarter is our goal to come out strong and keep it going.
Did you guys talk at all about, you know, you had a huge win in your last game, you know, avoiding letdowns, those sort of things, continuing to build on the momentum, that because that was obviously a really emotional win last time out.
Yeah, I think we just want to make sure that we're not complacent. Obviously, that's a huge win for us, but that's not as far as we want to get. That wasn't the goal of the season. The goal is to keep going, keep winning. So just keep going one game at a time.
Myah, I think you had 25, something like that, your highest scoring game this year, and you haven't had as many of those games this year for some obvious reasons, but was that maybe important for you? Not suggesting that you need a confidence boost necessarily, but to kind of remind yourself that that player is still in there when you're fully healthy and that sort of thing.
Yeah, I think, I mean, it's always fun to see your shots go down and, you know, it feels good leaving your hand, but I think it's the team we have this year, we're just so balanced, and so, you know, I had a night tonight where shots fall, and, you know, Saturday it might be somebody else's night, and I think that's what makes us really good. And so, yeah, like, obviously, personally, it felt good to see the shots go, but I think that's just kind of how the team is this year.
You just played really well defensively. You know, what do you think allowed you guys to have so much success on that end tonight?
Yeah, I think we've just played really together. We obviously have a game plan going into every game, and I thought we executed well on how we're helping and how we're guarding the ball. They have some really good shooters who can get shots off. And so I thought we did a good job on personnel and just in our game plan.
Tori, does it feel like, you know, you guys have had full strength now for a while? Does it feel like you guys are really finding a rhythm with your rotation and stuff like that?
Yeah, I think for sure. I think, you know, we're all playing really hard, playing in our roles. People step up different games, and, you know, I think our best basketball is still ahead of us.
You know, a good win for us after, I thought, an emotional, tough game last week. And so bouncing back and playing just really hard, I thought. I was really impressed with that. And our entire team did. Everybody that went on the floor today really competed. So our defense, I thought, was excellent. Offensively, we played great. We got good looks throughout the game, got to the free throw line, maybe just missed a couple we'd like to see go in, but overall played really well. And then nice to see Myah really be great at every aspect offensively. Shot the three well, put it on the floor, got to the basket, posted up, handled the ball for us some, really good passer. So really fun to see her play at that level.
A lot of times this year and in past years, but when you've played a team, especially here, that you're heavily favored to beat, a team that's struggling, it's not uncommon for you guys to score the first 10 points of the game, come out real strong. Is that something you talk about? Like, hey, let's get a bigger early lead and, you know, establish that it's going to be tough for them.
Yeah, you know, we don't talk about the leads part of it, but we certainly talk about coming out and playing with the kind of effort we need to and execution, for sure. We think that's really important in every game, but especially second time around, because each team's made adjustments, and that gives us a chance to focus in those first few minutes on things that we can do better. So I think the team takes that to heart. They really look at it and say this is a chance to improve, not just try and kind of build or maintain what we did the first time around.
Zudu, I'm not sure if that's how it's pronounced. She's obviously a great player, and she had 24 points tonight, but you made her work to get it. What was the game plan around her?
I thought we did a nice job one-on-one. So Tori, Myah, and Peyton had that matchup a lot one-on-one. I thought they did a really good job. But then around those players, I thought we helped really well. I thought we forced some turnovers, some jump balls, some tough passes when we closed gaps and did a good job of helping. She gets to the free throw line like 12 times tonight. That's not uncommon for her. She's just so explosive to the basket, does a nice job of finding contact. But as a whole, you know, I feel like we could have been a little sharper there, but we were really good against some of their shooters. You know, they shoot the ball from the three-point line well, and we did a nice job on some of those other players.
You and USD are up here, and everyone else is below you right now, and your players know that. I mean, they can see the standings and see the scores, and, you know, people like me are saying they're going to win all the rest of their games. It's going to be USD and SDSU at the end. How do you feel like your players handle that? Like having people saying that this is easy and these teams can't beat you, and then still, you know, not getting complacent and taking those games seriously?
Well, I know they don't hear that from me. I know they hear a different message from me every day. And I think just the leadership and understanding of what it takes to be successful. You know, this isn't the first year we've had that. So it's not like all of a sudden you're like, oh boy, how do we handle this kind of success? So we've been down that road before. I think we really respect how hard it is to win. I really think our team values the day-to-day effort and practice and preparation it takes to win. And I mean that. I think we really respect that. And we understand that, you know, on any day, anybody can win. And I think as long as we keep that mindset, I think we can at least play good basketball and hopefully figure out a way to keep being successful.
This helped on the 28.6% shooting. Do you feel like this was maybe your best game, defending shooting?
Yeah, I thought we did a good job of getting out to the three-point line. I think, you know, both for them, Jackson's a really good shooter. Boyd is a really good shooter. They take close to 15 threes a game, and we just prevented those shots. So I thought we did a great job of getting to shooters defensively. I thought we did a good job, for the most part, of keeping people off the free throw line. I thought our defense created a lot of offense, too, in transition. So it was, it was good. And again, I thought our offense was great. We just probably missed a few free throws that could have helped us. But this was a good game after an emotional one. Now as we flip the page, we get ready for Omaha, and they've always played us tough. I thought we really played well down in Omaha earlier in the year. But they've got kind of the front line to match up with us, and they've given us some problems. So we'll have to get ready and get ourselves ready for an important one on Saturday.
Is that the pink game tonight? What does this game mean to you with auctioning off the jerseys and, you know, supporting a good cause?
You know, I think it means a lot to the entire group. And when we get to this week and they write on the signs, "I pink for," it's also just such a strong reminder of just how much everybody's got going on in their lives. And in this particular case, with this particular cause, everybody on the team has got somebody that they can think of. Everyone's got someone on the team that they can support. And so if we can just continue to brighten somebody's day, let them know we're thinking of them, raise some money and help be a part of that cause, and just bring awareness to something that impacts a lot of people, that's a good thing.